Hello and welcome to another episode here on my channel. My name is ChaosMole and today we are reacting to the Nacon Connect 2021 live with my community. And we will see what they have to showcase. Nacon normally has like a test drive, the Lord of the Rings Gollum game, and then apparently they have three completely unannounced games. And I'm kind of curious, the last Nacon Connect was pretty bad. It wasn't as bad as Koch Media. It wasn't that bad, but it was pretty bad. And unfortunately, Nacon has some weird things going on in the background. Like they got basically sued by the Sherlock Holmes and Sinking City devs that Nacon hasn't really paid them the royalties, which were agreed on. And then there were some other bullshit going on. Like Nacon has a so-so history. So I've been following them around for quite some while, but I'm kind of curious to see what they will showcase and if they have learned, especially from the last presentation. Because as I said, the last presentation was a lot of interviews and not really like any gameplay. It's like, dude, don't get me wrong, but interviews are cool. But if I cannot connect that with a game, then those interviews do not do much for me. So let's see if they have learned or if this will be a lot of interviews again. Ooh, the bitrate on YouTube is amazing. Okay. I thought this is a already uploaded video. Like this is a premiere. Can you premiere live streams on YouTube? No. I don't think so. So I'm wondering right now why they put up another waiting screen. It's like, we already had a 2-minute waiting screen on YouTube, so you don't have to do that again, Nacon. Oh, there we go. There Peggy we go. 18. Peggy 18. USK 18. Japanese 18. Oh, come on. Okay. Devs, PR people, not devs. This goes to the PR people out there. Stop doing this. Like, seriously, if you are telling the people that you are starting at a certain time, then you have a 2-minute timer because of the premiere thing on YouTube. You don't need another 10-minute timer in front of all of this. I find that very disrespectful to my time. I have said this before. It's not as bad as what Ubisoft did. It's not as bad as what was the other one? Who did like a 1-hour timer and they told everyone to be there an hour before the actual live stream happened. And I was like, I think Battlefield did it. I think it was Battlefield. No, was it Battlefield? I think it was Battlefield. And it's like, stop wasting my time. Like, I find that highly disrespectful. Right, so they're still doing it. Oh well, I will put up a thingy on YouTube so that you can just jump ahead and you don't have to wait when I upload this on YouTube, so you don't have to fear about that. So if you're watching this on YouTube, smart you! Yeah, smart you. Is there anything else to talk about? Oh damn, apparently the Codemaster leadership is departing after 4 months after EA bought out Codemasters. Happens. Not great when the leadership is missing, but let's be honest here. They have probably done their jobs. I mean, they have sold the company for a shit ton of money. They got a shit ton of money. And now they are out with that shit ton of money. Yep. Let me tweet that we are live with the Nacon. Yeah, there's nothing going on. We have still we have still 5 minutes. Did that. Let's go back to the live stream. So we have still 5 minutes. I really hope it's worth it. I really hope they are showing some trailers here. Like, I really don't want to see what they did last time with, yeah, this is developer French name here. And he is now talking about the game they will work on. So we have this great vision about a game with video game characters and gameplay. And it will be amazing. Okay, what is it? A video game. Okay, you will showcase anything? No, but we wanted to tell you about our vision. Okay, don't get me wrong. I love to hear about developers' visions. I do. I think it's always interesting. But for this kind of format, and especially with how many games they are out on the market, frankly speaking, I don't have the time to remember your vision. And I don't want to sound disrespectful. I know it does sound disrespectful, but that's not my plan here. The point I want to make is, we are living in a day and age where video games are being released on a weekly basis. And we are not just talking about small fries here. We are talking about sometimes blockbuster after blockbuster after blockbuster. And everyone is trying to get the most important part of me, my time and my money. And interestingly enough, I am having not infinite amount of both of them. So, when you are trying to win me over to give you my money and my time, you really have to work for it. And again, an interview with developers who are talking about their vision about a game which might come out in 5 years. Yeah. Like, I sometimes don't even remember which games are coming out in like a month. And I have to look up my release list all the time because it's so much and things are changing so much. And it's like, yeah, I get what you are trying to go here, to go for here. And I normally would appreciate that. But in a format like this, where you have like 30 minutes or 40 minutes or something, those kind of formats normally take, people want to see gameplay. And if you don't have gameplay, if you don't have trailers, then you might want to think about not doing those kind of formats. It's as simple as that. Yeah. This is why we are not getting a Nintendo Direct every 2 months. Because Nintendo likes to showcase things and not just to talk about things. So, yeah. All the games that were showcased today, I assume. Oh yeah, they did Robocob. Tennis. Oh, yeah. Werewolf. Let's not talk about that game. I hope we will actually finally see what Vampire the Masquerade Swansong is. Is anybody using Nacon peripherals? Out of curiosity. I take that as a no, as a big no. All right, let's do this. Really? You are showing us the same thing again? Okay. I mean, that's good for me because I have probably already all forgotten about it. Yep, it's the exact same thing they just showed. Well, not quite as. No, wait. No, I think it's exactly the same thing. Yeah, it's the same thing. Also showing those information in French. I have no clue what they are trying to sell me here. Something something price reduction.
Nous venons de vivre une période extraordinaire. Depuis la précédente Nacon Connect, beaucoup de choses ont changé. Nous travaillons différemment, nous jouons davantage. De nouvelles consoles de jeux, extraordinaires, elles aussi, sont sorties. Les ingénieurs qui conçoivent nos accessoires et les studios qui développent nos jeux
n'ont jamais
été aussi passionnés et créatifs qu'en ce temps où nous avons besoin plus que jamais de nous divertir. Vous aimez les jeux de rôle, le racing, le sport, les deck builders, les open world. Vous êtes plutôt temps réel ou plutôt tour par tour. Vous jouez à la manette, avec un clavier, une souris, un arcade stick.
Well, that is unfortunate.
We gave it our all to meet your every
there
need.
There we go. Ah, that's me. I'm a dingus. Times,
we have a few extraordinary surprises in store for you.
That's a me. That's a me. Oh, Big Bad Wolf Studios. I'm really curious what they have been working on. So those are the creators of... what is it called? The council. They made the council.
So cheap. Have we always been so fragile?
I have loved the council.
Many lifetimes. I've watched empires rise and fall. I've played politics. I've fallen in love and stood by as love died. And what do I have to show for it? Nothing. I am eternal. You are not. But rest assured, the end I gift you is a greater mercy than having to exist for yet another damn night.
Yeah, I'm really, really curious. No, this is Swansong. This is Vampire the Masquerade Swansong. But yeah, this is by the creators of the council. And we still don't know what this game is. Well, that's interesting.
Hi, I'm Harold Riegler, producer at the Delic Entertainment, and today I'm happy to reveal some exciting details about our upcoming game, The Lord of the Rings, Gollum.
Gollum! Yeah, this has been in production for a long time.
Gollum has always fascinated us. While being completely essential to the story written by J.R.R. Tolkien, Gollum's long chase for his precious ring has never been told in detail. Yet his incredible journey from Mordor...
Yeah, I'm like, I love the council.
Takes players to
I think the council was fantastic.
Like
so I'm really looking forward to what they do with Vampire the Masquerade.
The fate of all of Middle-earth. Like, Gollum has pretty much
traveled
everywhere.
Become better.
He's also pretty much
the Bloodlines too.
And by looking at events from his angle, players will experience Middle-earth through the eyes and twisted mind of one of the most iconic characters of all time. All of that
I
his very own artistic
have to
style.
Admit
from his time in the slave pits of the Dark Tower to his stay with the elves of Mirkwood, Gollum will creep, sneak and trick his way past faithful, detailed environments.
I don't really care
some
for Gollum.
Which have never been seen before in such detail. The Lord of the Rings Gollum,
I'm normally like really curious about
adventure.
Lord of
it
the Rings
stealth and parkour gameplay and really leverages the Delic's expertise in crafting engaging stories. Gollum is no traditional hero. He's learned not to take any sides other than his own, and some of the most powerful beings in Middle-earth want him either captive or dead. In the game, you will meet some iconic characters, but also interesting personalities less known to players, but nonetheless essential to the events unfolding. We've been highly faithful to the descriptions in the books, depicting, for instance, the Moth of Sauron, the Lieutenant of Barad-dûr, who is constantly scheming on behalf of his Dark Lord. In the game, we will see his face for the first time, but also Thranduil,
also spoilers,
King of the Elves of Mirkwood, father of Legolas, and last but not least, Gandalf the Wizard. We're all super excited to be working on this amazing project, and we can't wait to show you more. Stay tuned on social media at Gollum Game.
Yeah, interestingly enough, I don't care for Gollum. That's weird. I don't give a damn about him. But hey, maybe the fun is great. Ah, Roguebook. That game came out 2 or 3 weeks ago. I've not played it yet. We have played the demo, but... I think it was okay when we played the demo. Alright. Hex Hecate? Oh, is this the weird... No. Is this the game they showed last year? No, I think this is something else. Oh. Well, sucks to be you, I guess. No clue what that was.
I'm Swansong, and I'm here to talk to you guys about Sessions game. This game, for me, is the best skateboarding game out there.
Oh, it's Session.
The way it plays, just overall, what these developers have done with this game is amazing. So, hopefully, you guys.
This is not Tony Hawk.
I want to thank them for letting me be involved as a character, and just you guys got to check it out. It's the best game ever. So, check out the new trailer.
I totally didn't get paid to say this. Wasn't this in early access for a while now? Skating, yay. Of course, as a kid, I had a skateboard. Of course. But I never connected with it. Oh, I tried out a lot of stuff, but basically when I got my skateboards, the next thing which was just growing was rollerblades. And so I forgot very quickly about it again. Sure, this is very important for all the people who love skateboarding.
Hello, I'm Jehan Russo, president of Spiders. Many of you are awaiting news of our forthcoming game, Steel Rising.
This was the one they showed last year. Yep. This is from Spiders, from the creators of... they just released the enhanced edition on the new consoles. What was the name? The new word game. Damn it! The name is slipping. This looks interesting. It's like French Revolution, but with automatos. Automatons. Wow, June 2022. They are far off. Yeah, what was the game which just got an enhanced edition on Xbox and console and the new DLC? Help me out here, chat. Greedfall, thank you. Thank you. Greedfall. Yes. Spiders make Greedfall. Oh boy. Motorbikes. Vroom vroom. But what about the motorbike?
It's Bob from the Bloody Beetroots, and today I'm really excited to talk to you about Rims Racing. I have been playing video games since I was a kid, and my first driving license I ever had was for a motorbike. So talking about Bloody Beetroots, motorcycle, and video games is
why
like
does he have
speaking
a mask on?
The same language on different disciplines. Being able to collaborate and create a
race
board and Nacon for Rims Racing is something really cool for me. Rims is all about the thrill of riding a sport bike at insane speeds. So I've created a soundtrack to match that adrenaline rush. You might already know some of the tracks, but there's a lot of exclusive music that can only be discovered.
I should have said,
guess what?
Why is there hay on the ground?
Pre-orders start tonight, but that's not the only surprise. Check this out.
Nah, no, not my type of game. Yeah, just my curiosity for bikes in itself is not very high. Like, it was early on when I was younger. Now I've reached a point where I'm just like, there are less expensive ways to get me hyped and, worst case scenario, get me killed. So... Oh, of course, there's the Deluxe Edition and Ultimate Edition and the edition of the edition. Oh, Cyanide. Like your studios. Oh, right, Roblox.
They're all here. The great.
I haven't played this yet. I'm actually still kind of curious.
What a pleasure it is to see you in action once again.
Yeah.
Another night, another conquest.
There was a demo, I think.
These lands will be mine.
I look kind of curious.
You shall not leave until all the mortals in this region have bowed down before me.
It's supposed to be very in depth. Ignore the rules.
But a toy to me. Those humans didn't have a chance. The dice were loaded from the start.
Oh, September.
Welcome to hell.
Are you playing as the devil? Oh.
Hey there, loser.
I didn't have the time to play the beta.
You really thought that Blood Bowl was just about spilling blood and wrenching balls? You're in the big leagues now. That's why you need a sponsor.
Approved by the best Nurgle team. Nurgle King.
Oh. I love the sponsors in the other games. Just dumb. I don't love them. I still don't know when I will play this game. I have never rage quit as much as I had in Blood Bowl. Ever. The amount of hate I actually accumulate in that game is not healthy. Oh wow, they pushed this into February 2022?
Hello, my name is Johan Druder. I'm lead cinematic artist at Cyanide and also co-wrote the Blood Bowl campaign. Blood Bowl is a turn-based tactical game inspired by American football, set in the Warhammer fantasy world.
We're just mentioning this?
Brutal, chock full of humor and satire. The important thing about Blood Bowl 3...
Yeah, the release was actually like, I think in August or September this year.
Mechanics are coming straight from the board game. I'm sure you'll
damn.
Like it.
Most Kai Hex, thank you very much for the host. I do appreciate that.
Some pitchers can even transform themselves during the match if specific requirements are met.
Like, wow.
For instance, in the Dark Elf pitch, if you score a touchdown in the
they
first
had a closed beta.
A Kraken appears, and the match obviously becomes much tougher. As you could see in the trailer,
and again, like the game was actually planned to come out in August or September or something like that. In August,
a bunch of
September.
Who are the public faces
wow.
Of these sponsors?
Okay, well, they pushed that back half a year.
Rejoice, Blood Bowl aficionados. Farag Gulchua is back. He's an Orc Stark player and a brutal and vicious one at that. In the campaign, he
that's
creates a gym chain with the Orcidus brand, whose methods are rather unconventional. So we decided to base the campaign on fake sponsors and star players for gameplay-related reasons.
I wonder what happened in the closed beta.
Their own teams from any race. This narrative choice gave us lots of
because
room for humor and satire.
This is the third Blood Bowl game. The Blood Bowl they're
license.
Following the Blood Bowl
Each
rules.
Sponsor has their own parody ad spot.
So
back to commentate matches, and during the campaign, they'll be paired up with a few guests who pitch in for the occasion. It was a great pleasure.
Since I'm not really interested in American football, don't worry about it. It's not American football.
Hello everyone, I'm Sebastian Loeb. I'm here today
it's a tabletop.
To tell you about the new WRC 10 game.
Based on a tabletop rule
know,
set.
The WRC is 50 years old this year. That's why Nacon and KT Racing wanted to celebrate that birthday by offering you a bit
it
of a
is
special edition.
A very different game.
The game's physics have improved drastically.
With a lot of bullshit in it.
I was lucky enough to try out the game, and whether on tarmac or gravel,
a lot of
the
death.
Sensations are very realistic, and they're different from
death.
What we could have in the past. The game feels really good. It was a cool experience.
And a lot of
apart
bullshit.
From that, you will find out about everything that's happened during those 50 years of WRC. As for me, the game includes my first victory at Rally Deutschland, my first victory on ice at Rally Sweden, and my last victory in Catalonia. All of these memories are quite amazing, but there are others. A lot of drivers wrote their names in the history of the WRC during all these years.
But yeah,
all
again, like it's,
featured in the
there
game.
Is an official rule book.
I hope you'll enjoy it,
and
we'll see you in September for the game's release.
I wonder what prompted them to push it back. Like, I'm really curious about that. Another racing game. Yeah, maybe the feedback was bad. But then again, like, they have done Blood Bowl 1 and 2 and they just followed the rule set. So I really wonder what prompted them push it back by another 9 months at least. Again, that's kind of crazy. Oh, a game which is coming out this year, actually.
I don't know about you, but I love trying out new experiences. So follow me because I'll show you that anything is possible. Last week, I had the chance to show what I can do as a chef. Every element of a dish is important, and it's what makes every creation so unique. The customers understand this, and the restaurant is fully booked every night. Fortunately, I am fully prepared, and the team is on top of it.
I'm not a real chef.
Yesterday, I was in Thailand to open my hotel. My team and I needed to ensure everything was perfect. We were fully booked almost immediately, and with revenue up, I was able to build
a larger
pool
and decorate. Manager.
The guests were so happy. I'm hoping to be awarded 5 stars. Today, I decided to travel solo. I'm a train enthusiast.
Are those all the like simulator games? Hotel simulator, cooking simulator, train simulator.
Express train. And tomorrow, I'm still deciding whether to become a surgeon or maybe an architect.
Life. Wow. Okay. Oh no, those are the simulation games. Yeah, those are the Hotel Life and whatnot. Yeah. They just call it Life, so it's multiple games. It's not just they put like one, like all those games into one. It's like multiple games, and they call it the life. The life. Oh yeah, that's right. They bought Rick. That's right. I forgot about that. I've never used any Nacon products.
Bonjour.
Hello, my name is Yannick Allard. It's a great pleasure to be a part of Nacon Connect. As we just saw with Nacon and Rig, last year was particularly eventful when it comes to our peripherals. In the last few months, our very first official peripheral for Xbox, the Pro Compact Controller, was launched, and we're extremely proud of it.
They were super jazzed about that.
This customizable controller for consoles and PCs is the first of its kind.
I think they announced this first to their shareholders, and it was like the big announcement, like, hey, we are now officially licensed Xbox product.
MGX series, specifically designed for you to enjoy Xbox Game Pass Ultimate wherever you are. The MGX and the MGX Pro are compatible with every smartphone on the market and will be available very shortly. The Revolution X.
I'm actually thinking about getting that for my
it's
smartphone.
A premium, fully customizable
I'm gonna lie.
Xbox
I love the Ultimate online
check
thingy.
Out this trailer.
Just playing some Monster Train on your phone when you were lying in your bed. Pretty neat. Weird enough, I never thought about getting a third-party peripheral, especially for Xbox, because the Xbox controllers are so good.
The Revolution X is the result of our combined
the PlayStation controllers,
design,
though, on the other hand.
And technology.
Well, PlayStation 4.
We can't wait to tell you more about it. Nacon Connect is the perfect opportunity to reveal some of our upcoming accessories, which involve another of your favorite game consoles. I'm talking about the PlayStation 5, of course.
Of course.
By the end of the year, two new Rig headsets officially licensed for PlayStation 5 will be available. The Rig 400 HS and the Rig 500 Pro HS. For streamers, Rig also developed an optimized streaming microphone for the PlayStation 5, the Rig 200 HS streaming mic,
which I'm pretty sure you can also use on your PC.
We will soon launch a brand new version of our arcade stick, the Daija, officially licensed for PlayStation 5. Thanks to the invaluable support of Kayane, with whom we already worked with on the PS4 version, the Daija arcade stick will be back improved and enhanced, offering an experience worthy of the next generation. Whether for console or PC, many more projects are planned for the months to come. For you, with you, we will keep developing and improving your controllers, your headsets, your keyboards, so you can enjoy the best possible gaming experience. Enjoy the rest of Nacon Connect.
Hello, my name is Andres Bordeu.
I'm Carlos Bordeu.
And I am Edmundo Bordeu.
And we are the founders and game directors at Ace Team.
And we're very excited to show everyone the new game we've been working on.
This is Ace Team. What was the last game they made? Yeah, they are creating some weird games. I think the last game they made was also very... What? What am I even looking at? It's by the way what I'm feeling here right now. That is such a weird ass style. Ass style? Art style. Also ass style. I have to admit, I don't like it. No. That's... Not my art style.
Time and chance.
I mean, it definitely looks different. I give it that.
Is to the strong.
It gives me some Ape Odyssey vibes. June 2020. Oh, there it is. Test Drive Unlimited. Vroom vroom. Pretty cars. Let's watch some pretty cars. Also, why do I have a feeling that this will get me DMCA'd on YouTube? Looks pretty. But that is in-game graphics. That looks pretty. Welcome, HM47. Oh good, there will be gambling in the game. Good, good. And you can gamble your car. Awesome. No, I'm joking. No. So now is the big question. Yep.
Hello, I'm Alain Janu, creative director at KT Racing.
And I'm Amaury Berry,
yep.
Game and art director.
At KT Racing, we specialize in
that developing
motor
racing
games.
That is coming out super close to Forza Horizon.
Our own game engine, and that we develop our own technology.
That is like super close to Forza Horizon.
Especially when it comes to simulation and motor racing.
Good luck.
Also for creating environments. We always want to
respect the places
we
render,
so we reproduce environments on a one-to-one scale. Test Drive Unlimited Solar Crown is first and foremost a Test Drive Unlimited game. It's a MMO, which means a lot of players get to play together.
Can somebody check that?
It's an open world, which means you can go off-road. All of the above is essential to the Test Drive Unlimited license, and we've obviously included that in Test Drive Unlimited Solar Crown. Hong Kong Unlimited Solar Crown.
The next stop for Test Drive Unlimited Solar Crown is Hong Kong. When we think of Hong Kong, we think of a big city, an urban jungle filled with skyscrapers, luxury cars, etc.
And it's like, oh,
behind all that are vast, natural
somebody wants to make sure that they are not
forests,
releasing in China.
Mountains, marshes, beaches.
Yeah.
Many environments that
yeah,
fit
okay,
a car
November.
Racing game very well. Beside the Solar Crown tournament,
I mean,
two
there's
clans
still like a month
other.
In between, like September 22nd and November 9th. That's
they
still
both
like...
share the same love for luxury cars and competition, but each of them has their own view of the world and is ready to fight for it, both as an individual, because players will join a clan and will try to climb up the ladder within his clan.
So there's still like
group,
a month in between,
a family
but, man.
Trying to overthrow the other clan. The player will both belong to and evolve within their clan.
We're glad to have shared all this information with you about Test Drive Unlimited Solar Crown. The game will be out in fall 2022, and until then...
Until then, we will keep you updated with regular content gameplay and additional information.
Huh. Still pretty close to each other.
Top story, Old Detroit. Crime has escalated to new heights. Authorities are overwhelmed. OCP insists the situation is under control. But the question remains, who or what will send these crooks on the run and restore peace to all citizens?
This is new.
Once and for all.
Judge Dredd. Oh no, it's Robocop. Close enough. Close enough. Oh boy. Coming in 2023. Wait, that was it? Yep. It's the highlight sizzle. The highlight reel. Okay. So, here's the thing. That was definitely better than last year, Nacon. Like, we actually showed trailers. But Maybe we could agree not to showcase games which are coming out in 2023, in 2021. Like, wow. That was a showcase, to say the least. All right. For all the people watching on YouTube, thank you so much for watching this. I mean, the only real game which interested me was Vampire the Masquerade Swansong. Like, that looks actually really interesting. At least the word does. We still don't know exactly what the gameplay is, but at least the word does. And it seems like we are not getting any Bloodlines 2 in any foreseeable future. So I take what I can get. Yeah. But again, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then there's a like button right underneath the video. And if you didn't like this video, well, there's a dislike button right next to it. And if you're also new to the channel, you want to see more reaction videos, more gaming news, and more thought videos on a lot of video games out there, you came to the right place, and I would appreciate if you decide to subscribe. Thank you so much for the support, and I hope I see you next time.